That's what my heart's telling me, but my mind's telling me, do crimes.
Wait, what?
Yeah, so it's summer 16 for me.
Oh, okay, cool. What is the whole thing? Are you having, like, intrusive thoughts sort of deal?
What?
Like, are you having, like, oh, geez.
What?
I can tell by your facial expression that there's something...
No, nothing's really...
It's like you're happy about it being evil.
No, everything's fine.
Are you aware that you're doing
Everything's
this?
Everything's adding up. What are you talking about? Doing what?
I don't know. Like, you're talking to me normal, kind of like straight face sort of thing. And then all of a sudden you turn the other way and you do like an evil smile and you started even doing like kind of like villain character thing.
I've been looking at you this whole time.
None of them know our plans coming together.
Yeah, no, it's definitely summer 16, but it's a close call.
Are you plotting something? Is there anything you're working on? Like a plot?
What?
Scheme?
No, I'm just...
Evil plan?
Finally. All our hard work shall come to fruition.
Get on the fucking ground!
What? I don't know. You're just acting a little weird today. That's all.
Yeah. Child does something for you. You just don't quite understand. Like, Dad, look what I just learned. And you're like, whoa, that was something, buddy.
Or my dad would be like, that was terrible. I'm not proud of you. I never will be.
Hey, that's something too.
He is hilarious.
Never be as good as me at basketball. He's got a hell of a jumper, though.
Oh, yeah.
Still does in his old age.
No, I know. Yeah, I've never beat him in one-on-one.
And he never smoked or drank or anything. And, like, you've already kind of ruined that. He will always have that on you.
Yeah. You know, you're funny, too. I just noticed that. My dad's super funny, and also you're very funny.
You like it when I do this?
No, you're hilarious. The bit about, like, I'm not good enough and never will be. Like,
I didn't say that.
Dude, I completely forgot to ask you about this.
Hmm.
The other day when I was driving, I saw one of those Little Caesars guys out spinning the sign, like, for the pizza place, and it looked just like you.
No, it didn't.
Have you been doing that?
No, it didn't.
What the hell?
No, it didn't look just like me. What are you talking about?
Have you been picking up shifts as the sign guy at Little Caesars?
You did not see what you thought you saw. You must have been high or having a common illusion. That was not me, okay?
Are you crying?
No, I'm not crying.
I was just wondering if you were spinning a sign at Little Caesars. It's not that big of a deal.
No, I'm not crying. Yeah, the $5 hot and ready is not $5 anymore. So what? It's nothing to cry over. They still have great deals. It's still one of the top sign spinning jobs you can get in the industry. I mean, it's head and heels above a car wash or something, or like a Metro PCS. The Little Caesars job's like one of the top ones.
For sign spinning?
Yes. You better watch your tone. And anyway, it wasn't me, okay?
I didn't know sign spinning was an industry of any kind. I didn't know there's a ranking of sign spinning.
All right, now you pissed me off. It was me, motherfucker, and I'm the best goddamn sign spinner on 6 Mile. And you let Joey, Bryce, and Angelica, they can get fucked. That's my block. I'm the sign spinner. I invented the triple twirl. And I'm the first one to ever stand on his own sign. I spun it. And I stood right on top of it like a little perch. And it kept spinning. And so did I. And I'm not gonna stop just because some bigwig from Hollywood. You know what? You struck a nerve, buddy. You just really, really struck a nerve. How about you don't drive around anymore to places you don't need to go?
Are Joe, Bryce, and Angelica other sign spinners?
Oh, yeah.
You
could call them that.
I don't care. I'm not invested in the drama of the sign spinning community. I'm just asking.
I will fucking end this town. Oh, I will end it. Joker style. Let me show you a little something.
That was pretty cool. Oh.
Now what? Who's the big dog on 6 Mile now?
You have like a full, like, is Dignan short for something?
No,
like,
why would it be short for something?
I don't know. There could be a longer name.
Don't ask him about his last name, please.
No, I know his last name.
My sister's name's Dignity.
Really?
Yeah.
Who's
She's a congresswoman.
Oh, she's a what side?
Tennessee. Thank you, no.
Yeah.
We are estranged.
Oh.
Riley's met her.
Really?
No. I didn't know you had a sister until this very moment.
You've met my sister.
She's in a bad mood today, dude.
No, but it's just like his life is inconsistent.
What?
At one point, he told me that he had a brother named Dunlap, and his last name was Durkin. Then all of a sudden, he said he had never said that, and his last name was Zazumba Zaffodil.
I never said that.
You never said which one?
The latter.
Zazumba Zaffodil? You never said that. I could pull up a video
right now. Pull up the camera.
Pull up the camera
and shoot it.
That's not how.
That's how I do my music videos. Run and gun.
It has nothing to do with what we're talking about. Literally nothing. Now you're saying you have a twin sister named Dignity, who's a Tennessee congresswoman.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. I just don't believe it. I mean, I've been very consistent about my life. Okay. Yeah. Everything's the same. I got a mom, a dad. I got a dog named Hank.
Must be nice. Really rubbing it in.
I got a brother named Keegan, a sister named Meredith, and my uncle is Tony Hawk. I've said that since I started doing this channel. Yeah. Okay, I've said the same thing every time. I don't switch it up for to start a new whole reality. I just stick to my guns.
Yeah, so does Dignity. That's why she's a congresswoman in Tennessee.
What the hell is hand, foot, and mouth disease? You ever heard of that with babies?
Yeah, hand, mouth, foot, and mouth disease. Yeah. Isn't it? It's just like a bacterial infection, I believe.
It's like warts or something.
Hand, foot, and mouth disease.
If my kid gets that...
You're going to kill yourself if your kid gets sick?
No.
Oh.
Kill my wife. In an elaborate way, then.
I'll never be able to catch you.
Yeah, I'll maintain my freedom. Yeah. Actually, I mean, the biggest trick I could do is convince her to kill herself. Ruin the marriage. Pretend to abuse the kid. Get the kid roped in on it. You like this. When mommy's gone, there will be no rules. You want no rules, don't you? There's too many rules around here. Aren't you sick of all these rules in this house?
This is literally like Insidious designs.
Yeah, I know. I'm not going to actually do it either, man. I was just testing the murky, dark waters of comedy, pushing boundaries. I'm going to marry a congresswoman and convince her to kill herself. One after another until my militia of well-trained primates can raid the White House. And lower interest rates this time. When I train them, they'll lower the rates.
Convince a congresswoman. Marry a congresswoman and convince her to kill herself. It's pretty cool.
I drove the subway my last time in New York.
You drove the subway?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
The pilot was drunk and passed out.
The pilot of the subway?
It was a runaway train, never coming back. Soul Asylum, whatever.
Yeah, and Soul Asylum.
I had to climb up to the top while it was moving, go into the cockpit, threw the drunk, passed out pilot to the side. I finished what liquor he didn't, and then I drove that baby, I landed it straight on the Hudson.
Is this...
Upside down, whoosh, inverted the bird and landed it on the Hudson.
So this is literally like a combination of the movie Flight and the one about the Sully or whatever.
What?
It's like Denzel Washington Flight. You just kind of took the plot of that mixed with
He had nothing
Sully.
To do with the train.
I know, but you're calling it the pilot, the cockpit. You said you landed it on the Hudson.
I did land it on the, I had to take a 90 degree turn outside of the tunnel and we blasted through the wall of the subway and we went through the earth like a mole. We dug through the earth. And then as I got out, there's a lot of space. The subway's here. The city's here. The Hudson's here. And we out the side of the cliff like this. I inverted that. Well, I inverted the worm, I guess. Inverted the worm.
You inverted the worm, yeah.
I landed it safely on the water.
Yeah.
And the liquid in the Hudson woke up the drunk pilot.
Uh-huh.
And I carried them to safety.
Thank you. You're such a hero. You tell a lot of stories that I believe.
Bill de Blasio really thanked me. He was the mayor at the time and a shitbag man of a person. And I said, no thanks, but thanks. I fucking love New York, man. Sick town. New York! New York!